Hey guys, I just wanted to start with the Plasticity series. So Plasticity, you might heard maybe of that new program. It just launched. It's a CAD modeling program. And yeah, what can I say? It's completely crazy, absolutely amazing. It's so fun to model with it. Yeah, check out the website plasticity.xyz. And here, Nick Kellen on YouTube, this is like the creator of the program. And yeah, he describes like the functionality, gives an update. And yeah, here just wanted to show you like Küchmeister Swagger. Check him out. He does like tutorials. Like this car is completely modeled in Plasticity. And he has like a series, like he doesn't talk. And this is like very advanced. So yeah, it's like if you're a beginner, start with something like what I show you today. Yeah, like with that program, it's super easy and super fun to create like all kinds of stuff. Like, of course, like on my channel, I'm doing like mostly product rendering. So I also will create products, but like for design and concepting, like this program, like I'm using that already like for a few months, sometimes here and there, but now it's launched like the full program. So it's amazing. And here you can just download it, test it for 30 days and then buy it like for just $100. Yeah. So CAD, like we will just create, like it's just an introduction and see like your feedback if you like it and just show like the absolute basic functionality. So we will just create like here with this reference from Nika Kastileva. This prop here. Yeah, so I plan to make like YouTube videos on that because yeah, it's just so much fun. And I also plan like to create that kinds of designs, like maybe some courses, because yeah, that takes like a lot of time, and then render it like photorealistic. And yeah, so let me know what you think. Check Nick Kellen out, check Plasticity, try it. You can just download it, follow along. Check Küchmeister Swagger. He has like absolutely amazing tutorials, but extremely advanced, most of them. So let's just start, and I will just show you like the absolute basic functionality. So when you open it, yeah, you have like this cube. You can just click on it and press X. And yeah, so like the interface is similar to Blender. So he's like very inspired from Blender. But CAD modeling and what you know, like from Cinema 4D, 3D Max and Blender, like the modeling is completely different. It's like CAD modeling, NURBS modeling. So yeah, I don't want to get too much into it because yeah, I'm also not that expert like in that kind of field. But yeah, I just wanted to show you and it's a lot of fun. So let's start. And yeah, I also don't want to tell you like everything about the UI. You can check out some tutorials or just completely follow along what I will do. I will explain you the shortcuts and we will just use, as I said, like the absolute basic functions because yeah, this program is brutally powerful and it runs on the most powerful kernel like on this world, Parasolid, like Siemens and all that stuff using that. So yeah, anyway, so let's check it out. So first of all, yeah, let's create like the main shape. So for that, you see here on the right, like different tools. So for example, like a line. So it's like Photoshop, you know, and when you close it, you have then here an area. And yeah, with this area, you can just click on it and just extrude it. And also you can activate with right click here, like show edges. And then you can just click on one edge and just bam, fillet it that way or that. Make a chamfer and yeah, also again, like create here, like a fillet. And yeah, it's so much fun. It's so fast. It's like, I don't model anymore at all, like with polygon modeling, because this is 1,000,000 times more fun and fast. So let's check that out. So first of all, let's create like that box shape. So for that, we go here like to a rectangle and here you see like this cube. And we can click on the top face. So bam, our camera goes to the top, you know, like, so we just click here on the top face and then we just click here. It snaps to the middle and we can just create like, rectangle, but to make the rectangle on all sides, like we have to press tab. So you see now it's going like that and we have like that line here. So it's like perfect rectangle. So let's just create like something like that and confirm it with right click. And we have like our first phase. And now what I want to do. Okay. Like this is really different, like from polygon modeling. But yeah, once you practice that, it's fun. So what I want to do now is go to this front view, and I have selected. So when you press one, you can only select like the points. So this point mode. If you press two, you can select only like the edges. If you press three, you can select only faces. And if you press four, you can select the whole object. We don't have an object yet, but otherwise you can just select it. And to activate everything, you just press tab again. So I go to the front view and press 2 for edge selection, and I select it, and with shift D I duplicate it. And first of all, I just want to bring like kind of one in the middle. One will be the top face and one will be the bottom face. So let me just show it to you. So I duplicated it with shift D, and then with the G you can, yeah, you have like this this pivot thing there, I don't know. And you can just bring it up a little bit, right click confirm, and now with S you can scale it, and with double S, so two times S, you can, yeah, scale it like in all sides. So I make this a little bit bigger and right click confirm it, and again front view, and maybe just a tiny bit smaller. And the same with that, I just bring it down here. So again shift D, and I just bring that down here, right click confirm, and you see we have then something like that. And what we can do now, we can connect those outer edges to create like a solid. So what do I mean by that? Like we just select this edge here and we want it to connect, like create like this wall on the outside. So we, like I select first this and then with shift click this one, and then here you have like options what you can use, and we will use like loft. So this like is the name for, you can hear loft, or press just L, and bam, you see we connect those edges. So you see we are getting like this outer piece here. So now I want to create like this lower piece. So again, I select this, shift this, and again L. And now we have something like that. Right click confirm. And now I don't need like those areas that we like faces that we just created. So I just select them with edge mode, with shift click, select them all and just press X to delete them. So we have something like that. So now if we press tab and we go here to the object mode, you see we have like two separate parts, and to join them, so this is then one part, we have to press J, and now we have to close the holes. And for that we just again select like with four, or like all those modes are selected, we press on that object, and then we have here patch holes along edges or create patch from curves. So this just means it will patch or close the holes. So we just click that. And you see, we have like our first solid. And now I just want to scale it a little bit on the Z axis. So I select that, press S, and we have again like this thing here, and just I drag a little bit like those up here. So like we get a little bit more of the proportions. Perfect. So we have like our base form. And now we want to add like this fillets here, like on those sides here, fillets are small, and on the bottom and top, they are very big. So what we can do is just like, we will select with a shift click, like all of those outer edges here. And we have like this little gimbal here, or what's this called. And yeah, on one side it's chamfer, on the other side is fillet. And so I make just a little bit of a fillet. And now we can just select one edge, because we have already like those different edges connected with the fillet, we can just use like one edge to fillet all of them. So let's just select this one and just, yeah, make a little bit of a bigger fillet. And yeah, so, and again, like I don't go exactly 100% the same proportions because it's just like an introduction video. and that will already take like some time. So we have something like that, and that looks already pretty cool. So now what we want to do, like, first of all, you see, like, you have like an X-ray view, and like to toggle the X-ray view, you can press Alt Z. So now you don't see like the other lines, and with Alt Z again, you can see it. So this is very useful. We will use that. So now we want to create like this gap here, you see, because we have like a top part and the bottom part. So we can just cut it out kind of like with the Boolean, but it works a little bit different. And then we will create like those like holes here on all of the sides, and then we go like to all the details. So now let's just go to like this front view here, and in CAD, like, you can do like awesome things. So for example, we can just here again create like a rectangle, and yeah, just created something like that. And now we can use that curve in that perspective to cut the whole body. So let me show you, like, if we bring that and press G and like bring it here, we can like select the curve which we want to use for cut, and just press C, or yeah, somewhere here it has to be, and exactly like here, cut solid, like cut a solid, this is a solid like object with the curve. So cut solid with curve, or press C. And now, yeah, you pressed C, and now here it showed you select target body. So this is our body. So we just click on it, and you see, like, we can cut it. So with right click, it's confirmed. So now we can just delete that curve here because we don't need it, with X. And now we have that body separated. So we can press G, and you see we have it separated, and everything is a body. So this is really cool. So what we can do now is select this middle part here and just press X, and we don't need it. And now let's create like those holes here. So again, we just go like to front view, and now we just can create just take a line. So now we want to create like those holes on, and for that we just go to the front view and go to the line mode and just create like the shape here, so something like that, and we can snap to the middle here, right click, and now we want to bring it on the other side, and for that we have the mirror command, so this button here, or Alt X, and we can just use that point here, so we mirror it on this side, or just use X, so we mirror it on the X axis, right click to confirm, and now we have like two separate lines, but we want one line, so I just select them both and press J to connect them, and now B to fillet this, because you see we have here like a little, here you see it like a little fillet. So we select it, press B, yeah, perfect, something like that. And now we also want it on the ground, on the bottom, so again Alt X, but this time you can press like this, or just Y. So yeah, we have something on the other side, right click to confirm, and I just want to make like this, I am not sure, or both just a little bit higher. So I select both, press S, and just scale it like a little bit. Yeah, we'll just make it a little bit like kind of higher, right? Cool. So now we have this in the middle, but let's bring it here on the outside. So with G, we bring it here on the outside. And now we can just cut again with this curve our body, but we want it also on the other side, so on the right. So we don't have to create like that here exactly the same again. What we can do, we can select both of these curves, and we have like here like in radial array. So when we select it, it asks us select solid, solids or curves. We have that, and then select the center point. And for that, we just go here on the top and go here to the center. And now you see it's like cloned an array 8 times. But we want it only 4 times, right? So we have exactly something like that. Right click to confirm. So now all of our curves are selected, and we can just press C and use our target body. So we get something like that. That looks already cool. But we just press right click, and now we have, like, if we press Alt Z, we have, like, you see, like, that separated. So let's select also, like, the bottom curves. And again, just press C. and select the target body that we want to cut, right click confirm, and perfect. So now we can just select with shift click and dragging our curves. So yeah, something like that, and just X for delete. And also we can then delete like our extra blocks here. So I just select them again with shift click, and yeah, it's so much fun. And again X, and also that in the middle. And you see we have something like that, and that looks in my opinion really, really good. So now what we want to do is, you see here, like if we go here to that part, it's very sharp, but here again we have a fillet. So let's press just 2 and we select all of those edges here. So all of those, and also on the top, but only this one here, like so on the side below, something like that. Perfect. And now we can just again like use this thing here and just fillet it a tiny bit. Perfect. So that looks really, really fine. And now again, you see like here along all of the edge, like we have like the smooth fillet. So we can just select one fillet on the top, and this fillet we have to fillet as well. And yeah, just select one on the bottom and one on the top that we want to fillet, and that will go along all of the edge because we filleted them already and they are smoothly connected. So you see, that looks like really good. And yeah, so that's cool. So now let's continue, yeah, maybe with like the inner part. So we need like a kind of a cube again inside of it, and then we can just cut it and add like this little details and all that stuff. So what I will do is, yeah, I will just go to the top view and again just create like a new curve rectangle here, and go to the center, and with tab I create like a new rectangle face, so something like that. And now, because we see we have again like little fillets, like this curve is selected, I press B and just drag a little bit around, so we get here like little fillets. And now I can just press 3, so I can select this face here we just created and just drag it down. So perfect, we have something like that. And I press tab to select them all and select that curve and X delete it. And yeah, maybe just bring that body with G just a little bit down, yeah, so it's not confusing. Perfect. So we have something like that. Now what we can do, yeah, like very easy, let's add those cuts here. So again, we just go like here to the front view and again create a new curve and just drag it along. So you see we can just bring it out so you understand it better. And with that curve, with that line, we can cut this body here. So again, we select the line, C, target body, right click, we can delete this line, and you see we cut this in 2 pieces. And now also the same again, front view, again line, and just here like make it like very straight. And again just press C, this time select only the top body, right click, delete this curve, and we have something like that. Cool. So let's create like this piece here on the side. We will fillet it a little bit later. So we go now, because you see we don't have a cut here, so let's just go here to that side and just press again like this face. And yeah, like I don't do it exactly, but very simple, we can just rectangle here again, go to the center and press tab, and yeah, with control click it's not snapping. So yeah, we have something, something like that is fine. And let's just bring it out a little bit out of the body so we see it better. So yeah, something like that. And what we can do now is we select the face, and yeah, like we will drag it out a little bit. So we have like this cube. And now I go to again like this view here, press on the face. And now like I want to create like that shape, and yeah, like I think the very easy way is just if we take like the line tool And yeah, it's always snapping exactly there where I want it. So I can just, yeah, point it here. Then I want it, I with control click, I don't want to go like to the edge, just somewhere here and just drag it out here. So you see, like now again, we can use that curve to cut the body and then delete those outer pieces. So just see, select the body, right click, confirm, automatically selected, press X. And it's just fun. And like, this is like so basic what I'm telling you here. You can do so crazy shit, like really. And yeah, so let's bring it then back to our body. And first of all, let's create like kind of a hole in those two pieces here, because yeah, then it will just look a little bit better when we have like a little bit like of a distance between that body and those bodies. So for that, I'm just selecting the curve, press G, and when you drag it and you want it exactly here on this body, it's like on the cube on the inside, we can press Control to, you see, like we can snap it to it where we want it. We can snap it to this edge, we can snap it to that edge, or we can just snap it here to the face. It's, you see, it's exactly on the face. It's so crazy. I press Alt Z so you see it better. Right click, confirm. And yeah, I just want to fillet it a little bit again, because you see we also have here a little bit of fillet. So just press B and make a little fillet. And also I want to fillet those two edges here, also just a tiny bit, because you see it's also filleted. And then we can just, again, because we have like a line which goes around. Let's do it also here. So a little fillet. So now we can just select one line here and one line here with shift click, and again, just fill it, and we fill it everything at once. So perfect. So you see that body will also exactly fit into our rectangle here. And now I press Alt Z. So we have X-ray, and I just hide this body on the top. So I select it and press H, and you see like this solid here on the top, like you have like this eye here, so you can just hide it and then and unhide it. So what I want to do is just create select this face here of that area and just bring it in a little bit, just a little bit, so it's going like inside. So I accept it and I select that, only the curve, and X and delete it. And now I want to boolean like this piece here. So yeah, it's hard to select. So we have like, right, like this piece here extra, and I want that as boolean as and create a hole to that body. So I select that whole body with shift click. I try to select like this little piece, and now if we press Q, we have like a ton of commands for like boolean. But here we just use, like if we press Q, it will union. If we press W, it will be the difference. So like we selected the whole body, then the other one. So the other one will be like the subtraction, so the difference. So what we, but if we click right click now, you see like our body is gone, but we want also it to do like on the bottom. So I press Z and let's do it like that. So again, we select that whole body here on the top and like this little rectangular body, and press Q. And now you see it's red, so it will be subtracted, but we want to keep the tools, so both bodies. So we just press T. Now we can right click, and now we can select that body here and just bring it back. And you see we have the hole, but still the body. So now we can do it the same with like this lower piece here. So if I select just that, right? And again, shift click and try to get like this piece here. So both are selected, press Q. But now we don't need it anymore, so we can just accept it. And cool. So now we can take our body here and press G and with and just bring it here to the inside. Perfect. So yeah, now you see it's intersecting a little bit, but yeah, for that tutorial is fine. Because what we will do, first of all, we will bring like that body on the top here again back. Now we can select that top body here. And we can just select like one edge and we can fillet it, you see? So now we get like, yeah, like this kind of effect. And the same right click, the same for the lower body here. We just we select like this edge here, and again we just give it chamfer, and we have something like that. So if we press Alt Z, you see it's like kind of sticking out, so it's kind of makes sense. So now what we can do is let's add like all of those fillets. So I will just use that body first, and we actually can delete this body because we can just mirror that whole right side with that to the left. So I will select that body, press Alt Shift H, so we solo it, and I will just use select like all of those edges here, and I will just give them a little fillet. So when we press Alt H again, you will see we have a nice fillet. So the same we give like here the bottom body, so we just select one line and fillet it, you see? And now like if we go here to that viewer and show edges, so we toggle them off, you see that looks exactly as we need. So now we can select that body and press Alt X and just mirror it over on the other side. And also we have like that body here, right? But on the other side we don't have the hole, but we can just mirror it over and it will directly mirror it with the effects we have applied here, so with the hole. So I just select that body here, Alt X, and just mirror. So I will select that body here, Alt X, and we want to bring that side to the other side. So yeah, we just, yeah, you see something like that. Right click here, show edges again. And I just want to bring that part also mirror it here. So again, Alt X and bring it to the other side. So perfect. We have something like that. And I think that looks really cool. And I just want, because you see, we have like two separate bodies here, and this is like one body. So I just select those two and press Q, and you see like Boolean again, but one will be dissolved. So you see here like Q. So you just press again Q, and then you see like both parts are blue. If you right click confirm it, bam, you have one body. Cool. So let's continue with this little, display here. So we go to that view here on the front. And now we again just press Alt Z, so we have like this X-ray. We take like this rectangle and go like somewhere to the center and just press Tab. So we have again like, so it goes like in all direction the same. So yeah, something cool like that. Right click confirm, G, let's bring it up a little bit. And I press 1, so I select only the points, and I select those here on the top, and they are going a little bit like more outside. So I press S and just drag them here a little bit outside, and I press B to give like a little fillet, and I will also select those two points, press B and give it also like a little fillet, and again just press Alt Z so it's not distracting. We use that curve to cut like this hole inside to that body. So select the curve, press C, select the body, right click, we can delete this curve, and you see we have it separately. And now I just want to bring it a little bit more inside. So I go to face mode or press 3, select this face and select this face and just drag it a little bit inside, and it will also go here. And now you see I want to give it like a little bit like of this chamfer this time. So I just select, press 2 for edge mode, select this piece here and this edge here. You have to zoom in with shift click, of course, and let's give it like a little chamfer. Yeah, so that looks cool. And yeah, obviously you can then just create like the material, something like that. But yeah, like anyway, so let's go like with this part, very easy. And so again, we just go to the front view. And now like this part here consists of a rectangle and a circle. So let's create it. Guys, if you like it so far and you want to have more tutorials about plasticity And so we can create like some awesome designs, and if you want like courses on that or something, but I want to start with tutorials because I also want to practice. Please let me know in the feedback what you think about it, and leave a like and subscribe so you don't miss it. So let's continue. We will first of all press Alt Z, so we have just a X-ray view, and we will create like a rectangle. And yeah, let's do it here so you understand it better. So again, we just with tab, we just create like a rectangle, so something like that. And now we want like here this perfect circle, right? So we can just create here like a circle, but we have to, like, if we press it long, and then we get like all these other options. So we want like this one, so 2-point circle, because if you select that, we can use that point and that point to create the circle. So I use that point and just drag it down here, right click confirm, and you see it's perfectly what we need, but we don't need like those edges here in the middle. So for that we can trim it. So for that just press T and select this and select that, right click, and we have like this shape here. And what we will do now again to like this view here, and we select both edges, press J so they are joined. And now with G, we just bring them to the position. So yeah, somewhere, I guess maybe here. Right click, confirm, Alt Z, and let's bring that just like to the right place. So we just can go, like somewhere here, and we just go, maybe here. Perfect, right click, confirm. And now we can press face. So let's select the face and just drag it outwards a little bit, so something like that. Right click, confirm. We can delete our curve here, and we just select like those two edges, and we give them like a little fillet, and we have like this body selected. Press Shift D to copy and duplicate it, and we just bring it then one here. Right click, confirm, and now we just want like to mirror it over. So I select both with Shift, press Alt X, and just press like that green thing here, so it's on the other side, and all four are selected. Perfect. So we can bring it on the other side. So Alt X again and bring it here to the other side. Right click, confirm. Perfect. So that was easy. And what we can do is now like those handles here and then like the cylinder. So again, very simple. We go again to the front view, and we again create this time a normal circle, so a center circle, and we can snap it directly to the middle point of that half circle. So it's so convenient. I press Alt Z so we can see it, and I will just create it and just make it a little bit with control click just a little bit smaller, because you see we have like a little bit of a distance. So perfect, we have something like that. And now we need like another circle here and then just connect them. So I have one, Shift D to duplicate it, and we will just bring it on the outside, so here. And now we have to connect them, right? So now we need like this edge here, so we just create like a new line, and we can snap it anywhere, because if we snap it and bring it to this other circle, you see it snaps here where it's showing 10 10. So that means like it will be like a tangent here and a tangent here. So if you don't know what a tangent is, like the circle has like an angle, and if the tangent is going like here, it's like kind of where this angle from the circle, the curve is ending, like this straight line is starting. Yeah, like if you're a mathematic, I guess that description was very high quality. But yeah, anyway, so 10, 10 is fine. Click it, right click, and the same with the other side. So again, line, just click somewhere and again search for the 10, 10, right click, and perfect. You see, so now we have like this face, and again, we can just press T to trim those edges we don't need. And now right click, and now again, just select all of those edges and press J so they are joined. And now we can first of all bring that edge here to the inside of that little piece here. So if we press G and we drag it, and again control click, we can here snap it to the face. You see it's exactly on the face. So we can create like exactly, so that thing is in the middle, nothing is intersecting. And now we can just again take this face here and again bring it out, and again right click and just here to the face. So you see that looks absolutely fine. And now we can delete this curve, take this piece, let's give it some fillet. So we select those curves, give it a little fillet, and now we select it, press Alt X, bring it to the other side, both are selected, Alt X, bring it to the other side, perfect. So something like that. And now we have to create like this thing in the middle. So we go here to the front view and again circle and make it a little bit smaller. And again, we can just take that edge, G, and bring it here to the face, select that face, and let me go to the other side. So I select the face, so I have like this yellow thing, and I will just bring it to the other face. You see, you can with control click just bring it there. So perfect, we have like this handlebar. I select that edge, X, delete it, I don't need it. And this we can just again Alt X, press X to bring it to the other side, right click, perfect. So that looks already pretty cool. So if we show it like that, you see like we have beautiful highlights because we have beautiful fillets, and yeah, so much fun. So again, right click here, like that normal material and those edges. And let's just create this thing here on the top. So for that, we go here on the top view and create a circle. And with this circle, we will just, like create the body and boolean it out. So let's create something like that. Right click. Now we have a face. Press Alt Z so you can see then inside. Let's select this face here and just drag it down a little bit. You see, and we create like a body to the inside. And now we can use like this white circle to create like an angle, you see. So let me show it to you if I bring it up. So I select the face, bring it down, you see, we create the body. And then we can play a little bit that around. So I select the curve, delete it, I select the body, G, and I bring it down. So something like that. And now Alt Z, and I select this whole body on the top, shift click, I select the new body, and Q, so we just delete it or boolean it, and we have like our other body here, so intersecting. So I just select this top edge and that top edge and just bring it a little bit down, right? Because so it's like this middle cubes here. Cool. So what we can do now is let's select, so we have like this edge now, and we can just select that edge and press Shift D. So now we have like this whole curve, and if we press O, so now I want to create like this yellow thing, we press O, we can offset the curve a little bit. So we can just bring it a little bit more inside and right click. And now we have like kind of the one side of the yellow thing and like the outside. And to create like that kind of shape, which goes like a little bit in to the center, I just select both of those edges, Shift D, so we duplicate them, and I just bring them up so we can again loft them. So that's what we did in the beginning. So somewhere here. So now I just select that whole body on the top and press H, so it's hidden. And now I press with 2, I select this inner curve and that inner curve, and I connect them. Oh no, first of all, I have to make this top part here a little bit smaller, because now it's like the same size. So I select both and press SS and just drag it in a little bit. So right click, select it, you see, so it's a little bit smaller. And now I can select this curve and press L, so they are connected. And then also this curve, shift click, and this curve, and again L. And now I want also to hide Those buddies here. Okay, it's like a little bug here. I don't know why. So first of all, I have to loft that again, right click. And now I select that buddy and press H again. So I just have better control. Yeah, I don't know. Like I have this purple thing here. I don't know why. But now I want to use that curve and press L. So this is connected. And also on the top, this and this. So again, press L, so it's closed. And now I select all of those curves and only the curves. Press X to delete them. And now we have like four different parts. So you see, but we want one part. So we just select all of them. So with right click dragging to left, then you select all of them and just press J. So now you see it's one body. So now we can press Alt H to bring everything back. Okay, it's not exactly what we wanted, but that doesn't matter right now. So now we have to create the sphere here. So let's bring it here to the middle so we can create that. But we have to press B, as you see here, new body, so it's not like Boolean. So we just create like a new sphere and select that sphere and just bring it down a little bit. And with S, maybe scale it a little bit. So yeah, maybe something like that. Maybe just a little bit bigger. Yeah, so that's fine. And now let's give all that here like some fillets. And first of all, also give like this cut in the middle. So again, we just go to that view here and create a new line. So let me here. With this line, I will cut this top body here, right click. Select the line, delete it, press Alt Z so you just see it better. And first of all, let's give like here, like this little fillet. So we select that body and so that edge and give it a little fillet. The same here, we select that body and then that edge, give it a little fillet. And it's also on the other side. Perfect. And then also do the same here. So just select those edges here and fillet them, and also select that edge and fillet them. Yeah, so we are finished. So yeah, that took already like, I don't know, like 40 minutes for you or something. So pretty much for that kind of basic, but because yeah, I explained like every little detail. And now you might ask, okay, now how can I bring it into Blender or Cinema 4D? Because it's a cat, you see, you don't have polygons. And yeah, like check out Nick Kellen's video for that. I will show you it in a second, but he has it's very good explained with that video here, exporting meshes. Check that out. But yeah, like very simple. So you can just press Alt. So yeah, to save it, you have to go here and you can either save it as a Plasticity file or export as a desktop and then just like to tutorial prop and then select save as type here. You can also save it as step file so you can open it in your CAD programs, but we need wavefront OBJ. Yes, so save it. And yeah, now you have like a ton of options and you can use here triangles. Here with density, you can decide like how dense you want to have the mesh, and you can use n-gons. Like if you're just using it like for that kind of stuff, and if you want to unwrap it and use it in Cinema 4D, like n-gons is absolutely fine. And then just play a little bit around with the density. So we have like nice curvatures and we have nice details. Yeah, you have like more control over those little parts here, but yeah, it's very basic tutorial right now. So what you can do then is just press OK. And then you have like here your tutorial prop, and that you can bring, yeah, I did like a little test here, into Cinema 4D, and we can rotate it 90 degrees and you see NB, bam. And now yeah, you have like all of those parts separately. So here you see you have everything separate, so you can just assign materials and you see it looks extremely clean. So like Nick, if you are seeing that, like really well done. And yeah, so let me know, guys, in the comments, feedback, if you liked it, what kinds of tutorials you want to have. So see you in the next one.